This is part of my Let's Play series for Fallout 4. And we're going to start this video just by looking around Longfellow's Cabin. Because it's an interesting settlement. Initially it's just populated by old Longfellow as his personal home. Which kind of makes it unique as a settlement. You don't really see a whole lot of places where... Actually, I can't think... Maybe I can think of one other place. I think it's an arena. It's organized as the home of a single person who fled there because she was worried that she was a simp and that she was killing people in moments of unconsciousness. Whether she's right or not is not really revealed. Whether she even did any of the killing is never really revealed. But... She's, where she is, I think, the only other place that I can think of where you have that kind of, this is my dwelling, okay, I'll let you set up camp here, and a whole lot of other people move in. And so, what you have is an old, presumably pre-war cabin. You have a shack with some good stuff in it, and you have a car. And the car is a little bit of an interesting...
Never did understand why the hell they programmed us to feel pain.
Because you might wonder, this is an island. How does a car get here? And I'm gonna walk a little bit around the island to show you how I think it worked out. First, I'm gonna drop off a little bit of the excess junk here. That I think I have. Dooby dooby doo. Let's drop off most of our mute fruit. We ended up picking up a fair amount of meat, and we don't want to be weighed down by that. It's the gulper innards. Those are the super heavy thing. Okay, that's probably good enough. So, how would a car get here? I guess if you're looking at the other bounds of possibility, maybe a boat drove it up. Maybe there used to be a ferry service. Which is possible. But a car would not be super useful just to...
Never did understand why the hell they programmed us to feel pain.
I mean, like, if all you're doing is moving... up and down the islands, then it's the distance that you're going to travel here makes it seem not particularly worthwhile. Now you see that the car is connected to this, which feels a little bit like a road. It's not quite wide enough for the car in parts, but you can imagine that the soil might have collapsed a little bit over 200 years. These rocks might have fallen from up above. But if we keep heading this way, what we find is that there's this kind of land bridge, and it goes most of the way to the island, or to the mainland of the island. Not quite all the way there. But this channel here, it feels possible as a road, not a particularly nice road, but a road. And you can see like there's stuff out here, and then there's a road. There's a turn in the road that just kind of comes down here. So clearly, looks like if you were to imagine people driving along, there's a right turn here. And so it looks pretty possible that it, before the war, this was just a straight-up road that went out to the island. Still might have been a single person's home, but it was a, the presence of the car is kind of explained. Okay, so what we're going to do here is we have a whole bunch of quests to do. Out here, and it would be good to take a stab at them. And it would be good to do it in a way where we can get more things on our map, because right now we don't really have any significant way to fast travel. Easy enough.
Looks like Howard didn't make it. I'll have to repair the fog condensers myself.
Okay, so yeah, he was sent out to repair the devices that suck the fog out of the air. And he got killed by Mirelurks on the way. And once we plug that thing in, I don't know, I'm not sure if it's actually... Oh, it is. It's reducing the radioactivity of the surrounding.
Making a machine that looks like a man. If that ain't madness, I don't know what is.
Oh, we just need to keep going. And fix these condensers. Yeah, it's pulling the junk out of the air. I'm not really sure if it makes sense to pull them this far off the road, because it's pretty clear that you can't walk the whole way without bumping into the radioactive fog, but that's what they did. Here's one near... near what looks like water.
Guess we got no choice!
A bit of exercise, man.
I'm sure it's open up the boiler. But we can easily finish those guys off. Okay. So while we're up here, are we anywhere near any type of map marker? No. Well, that's annoying. So we trudged all the way out here. Be nice to get something for our troubles, some amount of utility. Let's keep going. Just in the hope that somewhere out here... No, that's taking us back towards Acadia. So we don't want to head back to Far Harbour yet. We can head northwest. Okay. This is what we'll do. We're gonna see if we can slip up the mountain here. Using our Skyrim mountaineering skills. And this kind of forge, more or less. I think we're heading towards that one that's right in the middle of our compass bar down there. Maybe? Yeah, it's now actually present on our map, which makes it a whole lot easier. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, giant windmill. There's a little bit of flavor text in the game suggesting that Far Harbour and this universe had gigantic windmill things. Whoa, radioactive barrels. Bad stuff for us. We might try and get this cave over here on our way. Where is it? Oh, is it? Maybe not. It's actually kind of far. Whoa. Uh-oh. There it is. Yeah, so it's like interesting. You can't loop. Oh wait, you can. You can loop the corpse, but it's not particularly easy to do so. Oh, and there's another one.
Into the breach we go.
Whoa, a legendary one. That's not good. Are gigantic and heavy, but we'll get close enough to this cave that we'll just keep going until we get there, and then we'll turn and go to where we're going. Because I'm hungry to have this cave on my map. This is a radio settlement. We don't need to get too involved in them. I just want to have it on my map, and I got it. I need to clear the place.
Quit your hiding. It's you or me, and it ain't gonna be me.
So we had two Radiant quests targeting the same area. Both the Brotherhood of Steel and Cassie Dalton wanted this place clear, even though the Brotherhood, they had no reason to even know that this place exists. Yeah, that's kind of goofy. Okay, now while we're out, Southwest Harbor has storage drives, and we out here has power tools. Let's go for it. I like making my errands trips very productive. That's kind of interesting. A nice bridge. And a building down below. Our refill. Interesting. Some kind of a building here. place is full of super mutants. Wonderful. Can get up a little bit further and start taking some of them out before they spot us. Some of them are out on patrol.
Who's there?
Some might have figured out that maybe me or my companion are around. Just a little bit irritating.
Who's there? There's someone or something else here.
Just about took that. Gotcha. Oh, there we go. End of him. Let's see if we can get.
Ooh, we ain't alone here. Sure, something was there.
It looks like one of them.
Eyes open, something's stalking him. Themselves. Yeah, I think this is a super mutant settlement. I don't think you can pick this for yourself.
Someone there?
What we can do. I'm still going to clear it out. I think they did a better job with Far Harbour. Kind of making anywhere that somebody has settled a little bit a tempting place for you to want to build settlements, which unfortunately is a bit frustrating because it means that you will want to build settlements in all these places. Let's save. Because in the main, in the Commonwealth, there's a fair number of places where you think, you know, this would be nice if I could build a settlement there. But, this area, you can get almost everywhere. The downside of not being particularly good for defense against projectile weapons, but given that I think that the main threat on the island is more wild animals, this might be appropriate for here, even if it wouldn't be so appropriate for in the Commonwealth. Area. There are some wild critters here that are basically invulnerable and insanely strong. Interesting. This is meant to be like a maple syrup illusion. Well, I think I pushed myself over the weight limit, just barely. I really need to get my luck way up there to start taking... Okay, I could do Idiot Savant, not super useful. Better crits are kind of useful, but Critical Banker is one that I really, really find super useful. But I don't want to be saddled with being over the weight limitation. Uh-oh.
Got it.
You've got a steady hand.
Enjoy. Oh, did not mean to pick that up. The lockpicking minigame. Downstairs. Across the stairs up here. Let's see, where do they take us? Not that interesting. I am never gonna pass up. Don't need to grab me. Really don't. Longfellow always likes when you drink non-beer balls. So, just keep doing it.
Eyes open. Stop.
Uh-oh. Always, this weapon is fantastic to use with that. There are power tools. Cool. So, I'm not sure if this takes us outside. I'm guessing it takes us into the tannery.
Into the breach we go! Really wants to talk to you. I'm just gonna ignore him and fast travel back to Far Harbour. If I remember right, he wants to buy the tools that you grabbed out of there. But yeah, not my Not my preferred thing to do.
It's time to settle accounts. You hear me, Island? My friend here's gonna even things up. I wiped out the feral ghouls at the campground. The hero of our saga, Richard. It's only right, you... I think I deserve more than that. I suppose I could... I've been thinking about what's... You'd never want something. I'm sorry. Everybody was. He had a farm. The islands and... Grandpa, brave right. If you can take... That fog crawler's... That's the spirit.
So she has another quest for us.
Night's the worst.
You ain't armed. You ain't long for this world.
Water supply won't last much longer.
Whatever.
Those fog condensers are back online.
Good. Our water supply was starting to get low. Wasn't sure how much longer we could hold out.
Did you find Howard? He died trying.
Yes. Yes, he is. Well, I said it.
Thanks.
That makes two of it. Now, here's your pay.
Captain Avery's all right, I guess.
You been to the tannery? You find my tools yet?
Here are your tools.
A fair bit of luck. And now to work on the hull.
Okay. Some progress.
Bait shop's got everything you need.
You are a curious specimen. Despite our friendly town doing its best, I got to ask.
You're good people in some dire straits.
Huh?
Just mind you don't let them take advantage of you.
Most folk here are, heck, it took, but there's a way.
I'd love to change their...
Do it right. In olden times, legends say that once the would-be, you do this...
I'm ready to be...
You what? There's an old mire. Go there and throw, and then wait.
Okay, so I think that this
need
quest
some firepower?
Is hilarious and a lot of fun.
Show me what you got.
Don't try anything.
So I'm first going to drop off some excess weight. A lot of stuff I just don't need. This is a... Come on, quest marker. So it's a left arm. But we already have something that grants strength and endurance. Agility and perception is not really... much better. Yeah, I'll sell that. Don't need it. Don't really need... that either. And let's see what we can do to dooby dooby doo. Yeah, we'll buff up on our ammo. What are we shy on? We could use some more 10mm, I guess. Maybe some more cannonballs. Not the most useful of things, but... And in case we ever decide to use them, maybe some harpoons. Maybe some missiles. Okay.
The children of Adam are trying to kill us all. Drive us into the ocean.
Okay.
Hunter saw flickering lights by Eden Meadows. All unnatural.
And we're going to swim back by Longfellow's cabin to drop off some stuff. And then we'll go do the captain's dance.
Captain. Institute treats synths like tools, tossed away without a thought.
Except Nick recently learned that that is not true. But I guess he's a little bit slow to change. Up there at Dalton Farm. And that is way down there. So what we'll do is we'll start with the ocean area, head northeast to Dalton Farm, get it, and take care of clearing it out. And then we'll go down and do the captain's dance. Called anglers, which are pretty nasty. Not the most nasty, but they're up there. Not for that. And yeah, you do have to be careful around here. Much, much more of wildlife than anything else. Ground shakes. There is a marlin queen that will show up if you do enough of it. I'm not sure if there's enough eggs here to trigger the marlin queen, but you can kind of see that you could feel that the game was trying. Yep. Perform the captain's dance. So we're going to head back to the tannery and run south-southwest. Okay, so we'll initially just head south to the cinema. To see that soon. Yeah. This place has at least a superficial similarity to the cinema back in the Boston area. looking that weird kind of visual. So next we want to start leaning west to head to Echo Lake Lumber. That takes us in this direction. This place on the map. There's a house. Oil. And upstairs and all that. Whoa, not much of an upstairs left. Oh, I'm going up upstairs. Children are peeking and facing grenades. And it looks like it's injured enough that it's going to run. No, I don't really intend to live. It's a dangerous, nasty beast. Thank you. everything is disintegrated into dust.
Looking good.
Yeah, took quite a lot of stuff. Right. Okay, so we chased it pretty far. If we just head a little bit northeast, then we'll be Echo Lake Lumber. And there's radiation off of us. Yeah, this is one of the more interesting settlements in the game. It's fairly large, lots of different structures, lots of stuff that's been pretty badly damaged.
Loggers would come here to show off their strength by hurling tree trunks around. Come out and let's get this over with. Straight and true. Yeah, see what's left.
Okay. Well. There's that. Next, we're gonna head due west. And, and go do that Captain Stamps thing. There's already a good number of critters here. Really quite a large number of these. That's true here too. Yeah. Too much damage. Yeah, the game really, once you get decent armor, the game gets a whole lot simpler. Like if you were to attempt to do these quests long before you went after, or long before you joined the railroad, you'd be facing a pretty tough time. I can see that there's something over here. I'm not nothing. I'm going to get it before I do that. Just because it is probably a good thing.
Someone
to
or something else here.
To the left.
little bit more to the right, I think. It's just very slightly to the left. Yeah.
That's it.
Oh, and we can actually roast up. Which we're basically at this point just doing for some free XP, but it's a pretty decent reason to do so.
Sweet.
Okay, now we're ready to go do the captain's dance. We are. Wait, did we get it? No, we didn't. I'm sorry, no, we're not. We wanted to go to this place. Are those raiders? Yeah, those are raiders. We want to go and get this place, whatever it is, and put it on the map. Is it this building here, or... Yeah, Rayburn Point. Okay. That's what we wanted. First, before we start anything, we're going to clear out any... Oh, Dottie is our spotter. It's fine. So, any foes that we can find, which apparently are none. Okay, time to drop, I think it was almost any meat. Not sure if cooked meat counts. We'll see. Yeah. Okay. It's probably a little bit stupid that we, Okay.
Here we go! Count the ammo. Something's there, I know it. Not sure where.
Oh, and we have to do this again. Now we can just use regular Meyerlurk meat.
I got your back! That'll keep you. Guess we got no choice. Time to stop for a drink.
And somewhere out there, there it is. There is our big shot, a legendary narrative. That's it.
Into the breach we go!
Okay. if you're sitting in acid, no matter how good. It's now stuck. You can give it a little bit. It's done.
Why not? Ain't doing them any good.
And that did the job. So we gained a level, and we can just keep pushing our luck higher. And there we go. So we're gonna return to Far Harbour.
Everyone, times are hard, but this here feast is proof that we can turn things around. Now I know mainlanders have been responsible for all manner of harm, but this one is special. This one did the captain's dance.
It's true. I saw it.
So in my book, she's not a mainlander anymore. She's one of us.
Ha ha!
Food. Stim.
Here's to you.
Fully stocked.
Hey, Doc.
If these knuckleheads don't trust you now, well, fuck them, right? I expect folk will be more talkative now. Might even have some more work for you. Maybe hit up Mitch at the last plane.
Seriously. Thanks, Teddy.
You are the most peculiar. Take this.
Okay, so there's the captain's hat, which increases your movement speed by 2 and your int by 2. Which is...
Poor old Grandpa George, torn apart by a fog crawler. The island hasn't got a shred of decency. Grandpa George can rest in peace. The fog crawler is dead.
Wonderful. That's another with that fog crawler. That's right. The farm. Mm-hmm. And here's another two.
Really, it's...
Well, now, mm-hmm. But if you ask, that's why the...
Believe me,
if that's true, my late husband, Daniel, mm-hmm. One day, turns out some trappers moved in. Their leader was having a little target. You go and get that son of a bitch.
Wait, did you just...
What? Remember.
Okay, and so that is a quest, if I remember correctly, to free up another settlement.
Bertha?
Ma'am. I have to talk to you. I got 14 and a half cap.
A whole 14?
I know it's nothing.
Right?
Harbormen don't belong on. To get better. To grow stronger. Echo Lake Lumber Mill. If you clear the land, harbormen can...
You know, you're...
If you say so. I just don't want this pair to kill what's left of my kin. I know the money's a joke. And owe you big. Please. Help.
Okay.
Protect your loved ones with my fine hand cannons.
We have
Mariner.
Those tools you found are a joy to work with. It gave me this idea.
A cargo freight with a bit of arc. Best to do it soon.
Sounds like
the ship's the MSSA. Once you mop the deck.
Okay, there's yet another quest, and then we have one more quest. But first, let's take a look at that hat. So there's the captain's hat. Intelligence up by 2, movement speed by 10%. Whereas here we have Oswald's top hat, which has, they both have the same damage resistance, but this does perception and charisma. I am going for intelligence with my character, so I'll switch to the captain's hat. Does look a little bit goofy, but that's okay. The important thing is I really like having the boost to movement speed.
Everyone, make way!
Did you really kill the queen? The mariner said you did.
Don't pester her, Dad. I fear.
Well, Captain Avery.
Right. Here's a round on the house.
Hey, thanks.
Least I can do.
Mitch, I mean.
That's my own family.
Ma'am, Mitch is too.
My family was in.
You hear that, Mitch? Uncle Ken's the lap.
Crazier than a.
And Mitch sent him some of the.
But the campground's got. Listen, it shames me to. And find some.
I'll look for your uncle.
His homestead.
Right.
Okay. So there's yet another
Thanks
quest.
Thanks for helping, Mitch.
A whole lot of quests, or a whole lot of new quests now.
We're depending on you. We got nowhere else to go.
But I think that's probably a pretty good breaking point. We've done a whole lot of quests. We have our next round of quests, and we'll have to go out again. Let's see
hey.
Make go ahead.
Your thoughts?
A good hunter always.
Nothing else for now.
Back to it then.
Yeah, I was wondering if I might have missed one of the approval dialogues.
Institute treats synths like tools.
Apparently not.
Tossed away without a thought.
But yeah, this is a good breaking point, and in the next video, I will probably just be doing more of these quests. I'm a little bit bummed out that I haven't gotten any significant approval from Longfellow yet, but oh well. And so for the other places, what we have. Actually, let's just pop over to Echo Lake Lumber real quick, because I think all we have to do to turn this into a settlement is to clear it out. And once I have a place as a settlement, I often will spend a lot of off-camera time.
We can always sell what we can't use ourselves.
Charge up our crit meter. And then talk to let's not have things quit too early. There's always that tension. My flaming shotgun is better for raw damage. But if the crowd can pull, or if you don't want to necessarily spend a lot of time. I'm aiming. Yeah, I'm just a little bit wary of if they're charged, because I've been killed by those Got guys it. So frequently in with past characters. Let's see if we can get this guy. This now lets us use the workbench yet, or whether we have to return to Bertha. Apparently, well, let's head back to Bertha then.
You take your time killing that trap. Make it hurt.
I cleared the lumber mill for you.
That sounds like a... Wow, not really any cover.
We gotta go see the captain. Here's your pay. People keep leaving the island. But now that there's land, land to call their own, they'll come back.
Well, that
the farms have already sent word. We're going to turn back the tide. You'll see.
Presumably, people go to the moon.
Need to drown your troubles? Talk to
Mitch.
Someone else
in the flying universe.
Don't let the island catch you off guard.
By
my guns.
Talk with Alan.
Far Harbor.
I don't have time for this.
Citizens.
Hey, Bertha.
Excuse me, ma'am?
Smalls, we got no time for you.
The mainlander cleared out Echo Lake Lumber Mill.
Whatever you're talking about...
We gotta get off the dock. If you give us some of those Acadian fog condensed...
Surviving is about more...
Uh-huh. But we're no good here.
I was wrong about...
What?
Not you. You. Bertha knows this island better than you, Avery. We give folks some condensed and thriving.
I can lend a hand.
You would? Give them the fog.
Well, I won't stop you.
Sure.
Come, Bertha.
You might want to check up on Echo Lake. And take this.
How can the bait shop help you?
Okay, so there we go. We did it, and now if we move our mouse over here or our cursor over here, we see Echo Lake Lumber is now a settlement.
Guns, ammo.
It's not a particularly good settlement. but it's a settlement. So off camera, I'm going to turn this place into being much more of a settlement. But for now, and you can see that they're finishing setting these things up now.
I'm just so hungry all the time.
And we also ideally should link this to the rest of our settlement networks, just in case they end up getting too many people and running out of food. Anyhow, that's all for now. If you like, you'll see me in a future episode. Bye-bye.